Want the window closed just a little bit? Story? Okay. Yeah, let's do this one. We haven't read this one in a long time. Oh, I tell you what. I know this one backwards. You look at the pictures, okay? Many moons ago, in a far-off place, lived a handsome prince with a gloomy face, for he did not have a bride. Till one stormy night, to the castle door, came the lady fair he'd been waiting for. "I'm a princess lost," she cried. But the proud old queen was still not satisfied. "We'll need proof of that," she sweetly said. "We'll put 20 downy mattresses upon your bed. And beneath those 20 mattresses, we'll place one tiny pea. If that pea disturbs her slumber, then a true princess is she." Now the bed was soft and extremely tall, but the dainty lass didn't sleep at all, and she told them so next day. Said the queen, "My dear, if you felt that pee, then we've proof enough of your royalty. Let the wedding music play." And the people shouted quietly, "Hooray!" For a princess is a delicate thing, delicate and dainty as a dragonfly's wing. You can recognize a lady by her elegant air, but a genuine princess is exceedingly rare. You want to know something? That's not how it really happened. Want to know how it really happened? The adult version? I think you're old enough. Now, this was written by a man who was there, so it must be the truth. And you and I both know that the truth is not only good for you, but it's almost always much juicier, tastier, and funnier than fiction. So here it is, the real story of the Princess and the Pea, witnessed and recorded by the jester, Tom Tickle, who tells it.
I tell it.
Like it was.
Like it was. The month was May, but all was not merry at the castle of Rigamore. The king was under a curse of silence, couldn't say boo. As a consequence, the queen had taken charge to disastrous effect. I was moved at the time to compose a bit of doggerel, which, with your permission, may serve to show where my head was at the time. She's the pain in my plot, and I hate her a lot. She's the wobbles and wet warts combined. She's a curse a lot worse than the Crumbly Woods gout. She's out of her medieval mind.
Don't want to get married. Don't want
want you to get married, Douglas. Don't you trust me?
Yes, Mama.
Well, then, how can you say such a thing? Oh. I want you to get married. Why, only this morning I was saying to your father, I said, Sextimus, I want that boy to get married. Of course, he didn't say anything. He never does. But I don't have to tell you how impossible he is. He may be a mean, stupid, selfish, rotten man, but he is your father. And I want you to respect him. For myself, I want nothing. It's you I care about, and I want you to get married.
Well, then why don't you give her a test, Mama? She came all the way from Farfalot and...
Why, is that dreadful girl still here? I told her to get out hours ago.
Well, I told her to stay, Mama. I told her you'd give her a test.
But she's a fraud, dear heart. She doesn't have any papers. She couldn't possibly be a real princess.
Please, Mama, please. Just a short test for me.
Huh? All right. So, Studley.
Yes, Majesty.
That Harvey girl is still here. I've decided to give her a test. I'll leave the details to you.
Certainly, madam.
Now, do you still think I don't want you to get married, well, silly sweetkins? You are a prince of Rigamore, and you must marry someone suitable. Someone who's good enough and fine enough and sweet enough for my good, fine, sweet, smart, beautiful baby boy. And, of course, she must be a genuine princess, just as I was. Oh, that's what you really want, isn't it, darling? Someone like me. Of course you do. Oh, God. If I were only 20 years younger. Just remember this. You may roam the whole world over, but you'll never find another. Be it ever so humble, there's no place like your mother. Let the test begin.
She'll fail. That test isn't fair.
It's the marriage law that isn't fair.
Throughout the land, no one may wed till Dauntless shares his marriage bed. Boring.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Your question is a problem in mathematics. The question is, what do the following two sets of numbers have in common that they do not share with other numbers consecutive in either set? 12, 17, 35, 42, 18, and 46, 8, 12, 37, 14. You have 10 seconds.
Oh, but would you repeat the question, please?
Certainly. What do the following two sets of numbers have in common that they do not share with other numbers? Oh, I'm sorry, your time is up.
Too bad, my dear, but blood will tell, and yours didn't tell us quite enough. However, to show you our appreciation, there's a nice consolation prize for you. Goodbye, good luck, and get up. I thought she'd never leave. Take me for a walk. And I didn't like the way you looked at her.
Oh,
in the future, the tests are going to be harder, quicker, shorter.
Oh, Harry, I'm so discouraged. That was princess number 12. We've practically run out of princesses. We'll have to wait till their little sisters grow up. That'll take years.
Sweet Larkin. That's nonsense, because I myself plan to go and bring back a real princess, one with papers and everything, one who can pass any tests the queen may give. I plan to leave right away.
Oh, Harry, Dauntless will be so pleased. He admires you so.
So do I.
Sir Harry was true to his word, and 2 months later, he returned with a new princess.
On a stormy night, through the castle door, came the lady fair he'd been waiting for.
This, of course, was nonsense. It wasn't night, it was noon, and the princess only looked as if she'd come in from a storm.
Mama, she's all wet.
Oh, actually, I swam the moat. But never mind, if I just stand right here, there's a nice draft. I'll be dry in no time.
You swam the moat?
Well, we tried to stop her, but she wouldn't wait for the drawbridge.
You swam the moat.
We had to get a rope to pull her out.
You swam the moat.
I'll admit I was a little anxious, but my friend, Sir Harry, he's still out there. He told me that you had an opening for a princess. Well, any princess. I figured the early bird. Anyway, here I am. Who's a lucky man? Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you?
Hey, Nani, 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 no.
Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you?
Hey, Nani, 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 no.
Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you? Or you, or you, or you, or...
Nani, no, ni, 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 ni.
No, no, no!
Someone's being bashful. That's no way to be. Not with me. Can't you see that I am just as embarrassed as you? And I can understand your point of view. I've always been shy. I'm actually terribly timid and horribly. I'm insane to know which, sir. You, sir?
Not I, sir.
Then who, sir?
Why don't you ask yourself?
Do you ever say anything?
Do you for one moment imagine that I would ever consider you as suitable for any son of mine? Well, you are laboring under a very unfortunate misapprehension, my dear. Not while I have breath left in my body, and I haven't been well. Not well at all. I get these shooting pains all in through here, and this strange throbbing ache in my jaw. Throbbing, throbbing, throbbing.
I'll be right back.
Throbbing. Hey, it's a nut house.
No, wait.
You're the one, I guess, huh?
Uh-huh. I'm Prince Dauntless, the Drab.
Well, cheer up. I'm leaving. Your Majesty. Ladies. Men. It's been great.
Oh, I like her, Mama. She swam the moat.
I'm all right!
Twice!
I don't need any help!
Oh, can I marry your Mama? Oh, can I, please?
Of course not. When you marry, if you marry, you'll marry a true princess, just as I was.
I have the honor to announce the arrival of Her Royal Highness, the Princess Winifred.
You're a little late, Sir Harry. She's already left. And that pickerel is no princess.
Well, I have her papers right here. Winifred, Princess of Icomkill, Guardian of the Midgard Serpent, Warden of the Ragnarok Marsh Lily.
You see, Mama, she is a princess.
She is a princess. Can we have a test?
Oh, give her a test, Mama. Please give her a test for me.
Well, all right, we'll test her. Sir Studley and I will put on our thinking caps and make up a nice, fair test, just as we always do. And I'll prove to you that that cannot possibly be a princess.
Get her by the leg!
We'll test her for,
That's not my leg!
We'll test her for, sensitivity. She'll have her test. And she'll fail. Just like all the others. Fair and square.
Fail what?
Oh, every princess suing for my hand has to pass a test to prove that she's a real princess.
What kind of a test?
It's always highly secret.
Oh. Well, we'll worry about that later. Right now, I'd better get out of these wet clothes.
Oh, may I show you part of the castle on the way to your room?
Sure.
Well, you're awfully nice.
You're nicer.
You're good looking.
You're better looking and nicer, too.
You're a better swimmer.
She's it. I have her papers right here.
And she'll pass the Queen's test.
If she doesn't, I don't deserve to wear my spurs.
Darling.
My love.
Do you remember the joust on Whitsunday when you won those spurs?
Yes.
When you were named Chivalric Knight of the Herald, and everyone agreed that you might someday become Prime Minister.
Well, I...
Do you remember the picnic later on the greensward with the lovely cold pheasant?
Yes.
And you and I wandered away from the others to climb the hill and to watch the sun go down?
Yes.
And then we watched the sun go down?
Yes, Larkin, yes.
Well, I'm going to have a baby. The new princess must pass the test, or I shall have to go away somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Harry, I'm so worried. This could ruin you and you'd never become Prime Minister or anything.
Lenny? Hmm?
Just say the word, Harry, and I'll go. Far away where they'll never find me.
No. You'll stay here. Why should we both suffer all our lives just because you had a moment of weakness?
You're so fair. My time is at a premium, for soon the world will see me a maternal bride-to-be. I know I mustn't worry, Harry, still I wish you'd hurry, Harry. Harry, marry me.
In a little while, just a little while, you and I will be 1, 2, 3, 4. In a little while, I will see your smile on the face of our son
to be forever hand in glove.
I can see it all down to every small detail. It's just one that comes to mind. You'd better find a castle in the neighborhood for sale.
I already have. It tiny, 27 rooms, and the moat's a mess. And we could pick it up for a sonnet. Oh, Harry, tell me how it's going to be.
In a velvet gown, you'll be coming down the aisle. And it's bound to seem as though the wedding's only been a little.
Worried. What about? Lady. Which lady? Two syllables. First syllable. Bird. Bird hawk? Lark? 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 Lady Larkin. What about Lady Larkin? She's in trouble? What kind of trouble? Big trouble, huh? Big trouble? Oh. She's going to have a baby. Whose? A knife. Which knife? Sounds like hair. Harry. Oh. Does anybody else know? Just you and me. Don't worry about me. I can keep a secret. The question is, can you? Well, don't forget where you hid the key. Well, there's only one thing to do if we're to help Lady Larkin. Find out what the test is. You keep your eye on the Queen, and I'll keep her suddenly under surveillance.
We must think of a test quickly, but what and where? I need privacy.
Majesty, this is my room.
How wicked you are to think of bringing me here. You really can't keep your hands off me, can you?
But I...
We'll think up the test right here.
Majesty, I haven't even had breakfast yet.
Is that the way you speak to your queen? Kneel! I mean, don't I deserve some little consideration, some respect? Oh, you men, one of these days we'll make you pay for the degradation, the despair, the... Get up! You know I hate that. Oh, how dare you suggest what had not even entered my mind? Until now.
Majesty, I...
Too late! You can't expect me to drop everything and come running every time you feel like a frolic. Besides, we have work to do. Sit down. Now, think. Think of a test that looks fair and seems fair and sounds fair and isn't fair. Oh, your idea of testing her for sensitivity was inspired, but how do we do it?
A good test for sensitivity would be to tell her a very sad story, and if she didn't cry a lot...
No, that's not good enough. Sensitivity. Sensitivity, sensitivity, I'm just loaded with that. In this one word is the epitome of the aristocrat. Sensitive soul and sensitive stomach, sensitive hands and feet. This is the blessing, also the curse of being the true elite. Common people don't know what exquisite agony is suffered by gentle people like me.
Majesty,
get your hands off me. Think of a tricky test for that wretched moat-swimming princess.
Madam, may I suggest maybe we ought to.
Don't take all night. I'm not well. I need my rest. Not that I ever sleep on that lumpy mattress he got my back. Sensitivity, bane of royalty, that bed's a torture rack. Oh, I hate to sound grumpy, but my nerves are so jumpy. I am sure I could feel any lump, even if it were under the mattress and small as a pea. That's the answer! Under the mattress, we'll test her tonight. One tiny pea beneath one thick, downy mattress. Oh, God, you're bright. Any genuine princess would feel it. If she doesn't, she's through. Get the tiniest pea and order one mattress. No, make it two.
How about five?
10, I think, would be plenty. Better still, make it 20. And to play it safe in the event, even that's not enough to ensure that she sleeps, we'll give her a soothing sedative, won't we? You can whip up a drink. Something stunning.
How about...
Ah, but you're devilish. I love the way you think. She's insensitive, so insensitive. She'll fall asleep, no doubt. Love, but you're clever, brilliant, a genius. You are divine. Get out.
Dry. Thank you.
Your Highness, the King would like to meet the young lady.
Oh, I'd love to meet him.
Oh, Papa, this is Princess Winifred.
The King welcomes you. And he says he hopes you get 100 on the test tomorrow. Alas, madam, the king is still under a curse cast by a witch long ago. The curse says, King Sextimus will never talk until the mouse devours the hawk.
Until the mouse devours the hawk? Well, can't you get a big mouse and a little hawk and...
Well, we tried that once, but the mouse got scared and ran away, and the hawk bit Daddy.
Certainly has been a pleasure meeting His Majesty. A short while ago, I had the pleasure of meeting Her Majesty. He's a nice man.
See, Your Majesty, now that Dauntless is old enough to get married, don't you want to have that little talk, you know, man to man?
You mean about... things? You mean now?
Well, the king still wants to look up some data first.
I certainly do like almost both your parents, Dauntless.
We want you to be happy here. Must be a lot different from what you're used to.
Well, it is a little difficult making the adjustment to dry land and everything. Oh, you see, where I come from, we don't have any dry land. Well, some of the poorer people do, but the nobility all live right in the swamp with their servants and pets.
Oh, do you have any pets?
Oh, lots.
Dogs?
Frogs.
I come from the land of the foggy, foggy dew. Where walking through the meadow in the morning is like walking through goo. Of home are brushed with green and gold at break of day.
At break of day, But the swamps of home are thicker than blood.
I've got to change my clothes now and get ready for dinner.
You do?
Yeah.
All right.
No, Dauntless. It's bad luck to see too much of the bride before the wedding.
Oh.
Dauntless, have you been in there all that time with this lumpy person?
Oh, she isn't lumpy. She was just wearing a lumpy dress. Oh. She isn't a bit lumpy. You're lumpier than she is.
Never mind. Sir Studley has had another of his brilliant ideas. He thinks we ought to have a ball tonight in honor of our guest. An enormous, busy, exhausting ball in which she can drink wine and run up and down stairs and dance until she drops. And
he can help Winifred?
Yes, help Winifred to have a good time and help me to give it to her.
Oh, good. What do I do?
I want you to teach everyone that dance we learned last summer when we visited Principal Skipnitch.
Oh, the Polish Panic.
The Polish Panic.
Oh, the Panic. It's the hardest dance in the whole wide world. Winifred will love it. Everybody will love it. I can't wait.
Perfect. That dance would do in a bull elephant. She'll sleep.
Talking to Lady Agatha.
Not now, the guests are still arriving.
Now, is everything ready? Bagpipes, jugglers, gypsies. Everyone here serves fat ladies.
Just arrived, nice and fat.
Oh, they'll jolly up the party. But tell Sir Harry I want them all out by midnight. Three came in, three go out. I don't want them rolling about below stairs half the night. Oh, and the girl, Winnie Pooh.
Not here yet, Majesty.
Well, as soon as she arrives, we'll start the Polish Panic.
Her Royal Highness, the Princess Winifred of Icomkill.
Oh, Harry, next time you can raise it up a couple of notches. You must be the little Larkin girl Harry was always talking about. Oh, my goodness. You're just as pretty as Harry. You're just as pretty as Harry.
Thank you. Oh, Winifred.
Oh, Dauntless.
That's it?
We'll discuss it later.
We'd better discuss it now, Harry.
We'll discuss it later.
Dauntless, we're going to start the Polish panic now.
Oh, good. Do you panic?
Oh, only in bed. I get tangled up and caught in the covers.
My lords and ladies of the royal court, may I have your attention and cooperation in the main event, led by Prince Dauntless and Winifred of Icomkill, the ultimate spectacle, the Polish Panic. Come on.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Let's go.
I don't know it. That's it?
Uh-huh.
What are we waiting for? One, two, three, four. Feeling weary, dear? No, let's do it again!
papers.
But she's a direct descendant of King Surly the Squad and the Yeoman of Crouch.
Harry, the test is fixed. We have to find out what it is.
Well, that's cheating.
It's the only way, otherwise she'll fail.
That's treason. I won't listen to this. I don't know you.
Oh, that's convenient. I know you.
I won't cheat. A knight doesn't cheat. Larkin, I forgive you.
Dauntless, you all right?
I think so.
Dauntless, could I ask you something?
Mm-hmm.
I know it's highly secret and all, but what kind of a test does your mother usually give?
With Mama thinking up the test, it could be almost anything.
Well, like what?
Sometimes history.
Oh.
Sometimes it's spelling.
Oh.
Sometimes it's a test of strength and endurance.
Ha-ha!
Yes. For instance, one of the girls was supposed to lift this weight. She couldn't.
I can't even lift it.
But you don't have to worry. You'll pass.
Do you want me to pass? Mm-hmm. I'll pass.
Winifred, I think you're wonderful. Oh,
by the way, I don't think I ever told you before. My full name is Winifred the Woebegone. But Winifred's too formal. You can call me by my nickname.
Winnie?
Fred.
Fred. What a beautiful name. So straight. So strong. So you. I like you, Fred. I like you.
You're just saying those words to be kind.
No, I mean it. I love you, Fred.
He is out of his medieval mind.
I feel like I swallowed the drum. It's a feeling I can't keep inside. Everybody, come! And meet my incipient bride.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. My reasons must be clear. When she shows you all how strong she is, you'll stand right up and cheer.
With an F and an R and an E and a D and an F, R, E, D, Fred.
Yay! I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She drinks just like a lord. So sing a merry drinking song and let the wine be poured.
Fill the bowl to overflowing. Raise the goblet high. With an F and an R and an E and a D and an F, R, E, D, Fred. Yay!
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She sings just like a bird, and you'll be left completely speechless when her gentle voice is heard. With a girl named Fred. She wrestles like a Greek. You will clap your hands in wonder at her fabulous technique. Dances with such grace, you are bound to sing her praises till you're purple in the face.
Bravo, bravo, bravissimo, bravo, bravissimo.
She's musical to boot. She will set your feet a-tapping when she plays upon the lute.
Bravissimo, bravo. Bravissimo.
When the ball was finally over, Winifred retired to her antechamber to get ready for bed, and the queen retired to the castle gallery to get the bed ready for Winifred. Everything was very, very...
quiet!
She's quiet in 20 miles, is the song that says I'm quiet. And she's right in 20 miles, it's the service and the rest. And she's very special guest, if you dare disturb the rest. And she's very special guest, she's quiet in 20 miles, of the song that says I'm quiet. And she's right in 20 miles, if the service and the rest. And she's very special guest, she's quiet in 20 miles, the rest. And she's very special guest, she's quiet in 20 miles, of the song that says I'm quiet. And she's right in 20 miles, if the service and the rest. And she's
you follow the queen, I'll find Sir Studley.
One, two, three, four. Four! Just a minute, mistress. Me. Look over to the queen.
Idiot!
The queen will understand.
What will the queen understand?
Your Majesty.
Larkin, why are you wearing that tent?
Your Majesty,
Never mind. I will deal with you two in the morning. In the meantime, there is a little girl upstairs who is dog-tired.
Oh, no. She said she was going to study for her test.
Very well. Let her study. But when she goes to bed, I want her to sleep soundly. So I want quiet. Quiet!
The queen insists on quiet. She's quiet in 20 miles. Says the song is just a quiet. And she's right in 20 miles.
Dummy.
All right. Just one more question in arithmetic. How much is 3 times 17?
3 times 17. 3 times 7 is 21. Put down the 2, carry the 1. 3 times 1 is 3, plus the 1 you carried is 24.
Well, that's not what the book says. Well, maybe you better just add up 3 17s and see what you get.
Add up 3 17s and see what you get. 7, 14, 21, 22, 23, 24. The same thing.
Sure is. The book is wrong and you're right. If Mama tests you in arithmetic, you're sure to pass, Fred. Now, that just leaves history.
Oh, Dauntless, look at the time.
It's early.
No, it's late. You better go.
Oh, Fred, I don't want to go.
I don't want you to go, but tomorrow's a big day for both of us.
Well.
Oh, better leave the history book.
I'm positive you're going to pass Mama's test tomorrow. Well, I'm pretty sure. If you don't, I'll understand.
And so it was that soon after his encounter with the dragon Fafnir, Prince Siegfried fell into the enchanted mud. And before long, his head grew back. Whereupon he married the Princess Brunhilde, and they lived happily ever after. Well, I'm glad. They all lived happily, happily, happily ever after.
The couple is happily leaving the chapel eternally tied. As the curtain descends, there is nothing but loving and laughter. When the fairy tale ends, the heroine's always a bride. Ella, the girl of the cinders, did the wash and the walls and the winders. But she married a prince who was brawny and blue-eyed and blonde. Still, I honestly doubt that she could ever have done it without that crazy lady with the wand. Cinderella had outside help. I have no one but me, fairy godmother, 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 where can you be? I haven't got a fairy godmother. I haven't even got a godmother. I've got a mother, a plain, ordinary woman. Snow White was so pretty, they tell us, that the queen was insulted and jealous when the mirror declared that Snow White was the fairest of all. She was dumped on the border, but was saved by some men who adored her. Oh, I grant you, they were small, but there were seven of them, practically a regiment. I'm alone in the night. Myself, not a dwarf, not an elf, not a goblin in sight. That girl had seven determined little men working day and night just for her. Oh, sure, the queen gave her a poison apple. Even so, she lived happily, happily, happily ever after. A magical kiss counteracted the apple eventually. Though I know I'm not clever, I'll do what they tell me I have. One simple human desire. Oh, I ask for no more than two boots on the floor next to mine. Someone to fly and to float with, and to swim in the marsh and the moat with. As for this one, he'd be fine. But it'll never happen if I don't pass the test. It's up to me. And I'm burning to bring in a vow. If I don't, I'll be stuck with goodbye and good luck again.
Certainly, Majesty. Here it is.
Oh, the smallest pea in the kingdom under 20 goose down mattresses. Divine. Is that it? Where is it? She'll never feel it. She'll sleep like a slug. And if she sleeps, she fails.
Thank you.
you find out what the test is? What is it? Ingenious. Come on.
Over here. Larkin, I've changed my mind.
What do you mean?
I'll cheat.
Oh, will you? Do you promise, Harry?
On my honor as a knight, I'll cheat.
Door. Tomorrow, it'll be our door.
Douglas! Darling, what are you doing up at this hour? Well, now, you run along to bed. Mama's busy, but as soon as Mama's free, she'll come and tuck you in.
After I say goodnight to Fred once more.
Douglas!
Mama! Yes, Mama.
Oh. Come along, ladies.
I won't go straight to bed. And she won't tuck me in ever again. I'm 36 years old. Stay up till dawn if I want to. Dawn. The dawn of my wedding day. Oh, Papa. Oh, don't worry about Mama, Papa. She's busy making sure that Winifred gets a good night's sleep. Oh, Papa. Tomorrow is my wedding day. And tomorrow night is my wedding night. Remember you were going to have a little talk with me? You know, man to man. Well, Papa, what's it all about? What is it you have to tell me? Well, Papa? All right, Papa. Stop. Look. Listen. Stop, look, listen. Man. A little man. Boy. Flower. Girl. Flower. Boy, flower, girl, flower. Oh, tell me more. I want to know about what getting married is for. Seed in girl flower. Bee on boy flower. The boy flower dust gets on bee. Bee flies to girl flower. Dust touches girl flower seed. Oh, I see. No, I don't see. It's very interesting, but still not clear to me. Carrie. Sounds like Carrie? Mary. Man and woman get married.
Winifred in white. Love each other. Night. One night. And then one night? Yes, yes, one night. It's very interesting what happens in the night. What happens? What happens? Oh, Father, tell me, please. Shall I go and pick some flowers? Shall I go and catch some bees? Princess Winifred and I will get married. Night, one night. And then one night. And then one night. What? What happens in the night, Papa? Stork? Stork will come and bring us a baby? Papa, I know all about the stork. Mama told me about that years ago. Wait a minute, Papa. Flower, seed, man, woman, bee, baby, small. It isn't the stork! It isn't the stork! It isn't the stork at all! Oh, life is grand. It's very interesting. I think I understand. I think I know. It's very interesting. Thank you, Father. And Father, I love you so.
That should do it. And one tiny pea. The smallest pea in the kingdom. Now, have you brought everything?
Yes, Your Majesty.
And the girl, where is that Winnie whatever? There you are, my dear. All ready for it. You must be sure and get a good night's sleep tonight so you'll be fresh early tomorrow morning for your trip back to your kingdom or wherever you're going. Bring the hypnotic mirror.
Here, madame.
Well, where is the incantation? Studley said it would be written right on the wrapper. Silk and swishing sibilance wraps us in a gentle trance. Deep in mortal's arms we lie. Off we go to beddy by.
You know, I think I'm getting a sty right here.
Bring the sleeping draught. Drink a little warm milk and extract of opium before going to bed, I always say. Drink it down. Get out. Now, I'm sure we're going to get a good night's sleep. I wish I could say the same for myself. Well, now, my dear, why aren't we in bed? At
least one person in this castle is going to get a good night's sleep. So early in the morning.
Well, today's the test, Mama, and I want to look my best for Fred.
The test? Why, Dauntless, the test is all over, sweetheart.
What?
The test is all over, pussycat.
Well, Mama, when was it? What was it?
It was last night. We put her to bed on 20 soft, downy mattresses with a pea under the bottom one to test her sensitivity. And of course, a pea would have kept a true princess awake.
And she slept?
Well, darling, I'm sure I don't know, but she was practically falling asleep before she even got into bed and yawning like a vulgar scullery maid. I mean, she looked ghastly, darling, and old enough to be your... Well, we'll see.
Oh, Fred.
You were surprised when I told you about Lady Larkin. You'll be even more surprised when I tell you about Lady Rowena, Lady Martha, Lady Agnes, and me.
The Queen and Prince Dauntless.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Majesty.
Oh, here to see that Ralph on her way.
It's Fred, Mama.
Well, whatever. Since she is such a great favorite of ours, we have decided that she shall receive an extra special consolation prize. Sir Studley?
A very thoughtful gift, Majesty.
Oh, charming, charming. Well, and where is our little slug-a-bib? She should be getting an early start.
37,427.
Here she is.
37,427.
37,428. What shape?
What do you stuff your mattresses with anyway, jousting equipment?
What do you mean?
I mean, that bed ought to be moved down to the torture chamber.
You didn't sleep?
I never shut my eyes.
You passed.
Passed what?
The test. Mama put a pea under 20 mattresses, and you felt it, and now we can be married.
A pea? Under 20 mattresses? Well, no wonder I'm black and blue. Dauntless, why don't you shop around for a small kingdom for us somewhere?
I got a feeling we're not gonna want to live here.
She's going to get cold sleeping on that bare table. I'd better take her up to our room.
Dauntless, wait.
Shh, Mama, she's asleep.
I will not stand by and let you throw yourself away on this ill-bred, vulgar swap, sir.
Mama.
I mean, with those shifty little eyes and that mean
Mama, I told you to shut up!
The prophecy has come true. The mouse devoured the hawk.
Look, the queen can't talk.
I.
What?
I can. And I've got a lot to say.
Good night, everybody.
Unhand the boy. Go ahead. Now you ask for it, Agravaine, and you got it. From now on, when I say hop, I want you to hop. Hop! Jump! Jump! It wasn't a pea. It wasn't a pea. It wasn't a pea at all.